Hello. Me see if I move my table the right way. Okay, I think I did. How is everybody? Hey, everybody. Hey, Mel Mel. Okay, if you jump on, say hey. If you're new, tell me where you're from. Okay, so I watched a video on YouTube because my potted plants in the summertime, they need to be watered like every day. Hey, Debbie. And you know that's just about impossible when you have a life and you're busy and you're always doing stuff, always doing stuff. I'm always doing stuff. So this video I researched about potted plants. Like I've seen, you know, you can put a disposable diaper in the underneath the dirt, and it's supposed to, you know, how they get wet. Like when a baby gets in a pool, they swell up and they're full of water. I've tried that. It don't work. Don't even try it. It don't work. Didn't work for me. I think we're just too hot and dry. Well, we're not really dry, but we're too hot in Florida. The sun's too hot. And has anybody ever, you know, you have to repot a plant, and you go to repot the plant, you take it out of its container. And the dirt is just super dry and crumbly and just tear. It's like what it does is the dirt gets so compact and dry, okay? And let's just say you water it with the hose, and you're soaking it. You are drowning it with water, and all the water is just running off. And so you're like, I watered that plant enough. Surely that it's wet. Well, when the dirt gets like that, it repels the water. It does not go in where the plant roots are, and it needs it. So it just repels the water off. And 2 days later, it's just a dry ball of dirt again. So has anybody else had that happen? I know you have, Mau Mau. So this stuff that I watched this guy do a video is amazing because I did try it. I got it in the mail last week. I ordered it from Amazon because I couldn't find it at Home Depot. And I'm gonna hold it up here. So if any of y'all want to do a screenshot, let me make sure I'm in front of the camera. If you want to do a screenshot, or write it down. It's called high yield spreader sticker. They use this on crops. You know, farmers use it. Of course, they buy a bigger bottle than that, but this conditions the soil so the water stays in the dirt, even if it's already a dried clump of dirt. You can put this on it and your dirt will start keeping the water in the plant. Now, how cool is that? So, I have a gallon pitcher here and I wrote on it with a permanent marker spreader sticker so I know what it is. Okay. And all you have to do is got my measuring spoon. When I tried it, I made a very small batch. So that's why I'm going to make a new one. And I'm going to, let's see. The most you put in is 2 teaspoons per gallon. 2 teaspoons of this per gallon. Hey, Miss Ella. Okay, so let me show you. This is my teaspoon. Let me show you how it's thick like honey. So there's one. Okay. 2. Oh my goodness, somebody's trying to call me. I hope it doesn't butt me off. So I'm going to stir it around. Let me see if I can tell who's calling. Whoever it was, I didn't know them. Okay, so I am going to follow the directions. I am that type of person, like when I use Roundup and stuff, they say, you know, however many ounces to a gallon. I always put a little more in. I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to do the 2 teaspoons in the gallon of water. Because I'm going to trust this guy when he says follow directions. Hey, Cheryl. So this is what it is. 2 teaspoons per gallon of water. Okay. And it made it look, you know, it's not clear now. It's kind of, you know, milky looking. Okay, so we have that mixed. Okay, the other thing that he suggested, and you do this once to twice a week, depending on if you think it needs it, both of them. So this one is going to be, oh, am I still on? I think I am. Okay, the other one is, this is different from Miracle-Gro. And the difference is that it has the high number in the middle. It's called Blooming and Rooting. And you want that high number in the middle. Okay? So that's that if you want to do a screenshot or write it down. Of course, you can watch the replay and get the information. But this looks like the, let me read how much we need here. Potted or container plants, 1 teaspoon in 1 gallon of water. Okay, that's not very much. So this bag will last quite a long time. Hey, Melissa. Now, this looks just like the Miracle-Gro that you put in the water. It's blue, just like Miracle-Gro, but it's not, because you want that high number in the middle. So, 1 teaspoon, and it comes with a little scoop. Put that in there. I should have brought a... I do have a spoon out here. I'm gonna stir that up. Okay, so this one looks blue. Hey, Amanda. Okay, so I did the same thing. This is a gallon jug. I put exactly 1 gallon of water in it. And I marked it with a Sharpie. Just so I always know what's in here. Okay, so now we're going to plant some potted plants. Okay, now, this man that I watched on YouTube has a lawn and garden store. And he had these big, beautiful hanging baskets, which is what I have the most trouble with, is my hanging baskets get all dried up. He had, just like Busch Gardens or, you know, any of those places, they have these huge, beautiful baskets of flowers. And the basket is only this size. But the flowers are huge and they hang down like, I don't know, 5 foot. And I always wondered, how do they do that? Well, he has the same thing out front of his store. And he showed it to me on the video. He just buys a potted plant. He keeps it in this container, okay? Because they do plant them in good soil. This is, I can't even pronounce that name, but here's the tag. And it was $15, which I think is a little pricey. I don't really like paying that kind of money, but I did. I bought this last weekend, so now I've had this about a week, and it really needs to have this magic potion going on. See if I can get this tag out. I think I'm just gonna cut it. Okay, let me show you the tag again. But these are like the mini petunias, the mini bells. Okay, but if I can get a basket to look like his, I'm gonna be very happy. Okay, but I don't want the pot showing. And I don't need, because I'm putting it in a basket, I don't need this hanger on top. You know what? I'm just going to cut it because I can't even see. I can't even see how to get it off of there. I'm just going to cut the... top of this off. Okay, so I just cut that off. How is everybody tonight? How is everyone? Hey, Amy. I just saw you, girl. How are you? So now, this cocoa liner, I'm pretty sure I got it Dollar General, $2.50, and I actually think I got it after summer, and they were like, buy one, get one, because I've had them a while. But all I'm going to do is I'm going to set the cocoa liner in there, okay? Then I'm going to set my pot on top of that. I'm keeping it in the original pot. And as excited as I am about this, I will tell you, I am going to keep you posted about how this does. But this, she needs some water. She does, because I haven't, I think I watered it one time in a week. But it could look better. Hey, Emily. Okay, so the first thing we're going to put on is the spreader sticker. Okay, this is going to keep the dirt. Let me feel under here and see how moist it is. It's a tad bit moist, but it's not. Oh, and you don't need much. You don't need like a ton. Just get it to the dirt. Okay, that wasn't very much. Okay. Hey, Donna. Hey, girl. All right, now I'm gonna do the blooming and rooting. This is what is supposed to make it flower. Flower. So I'm going to water it some over the spreader sticker. I put a little more of that than the other. Okay, now let me see if I can untangle my chain here. See, she needed some attention because I do have little, I have stuff coming off of it. Okay, so I'm going to fix my chain. Okay, and I'm going to hang it up on my porch here. Okay, and we're going to keep an eye on that. And look, not much water came out of it. That's what that spreader sticker does. It keeps the water in the plant. Okay, that's a hot mess. But I told you we're going to get our hands dirty. Okay, now I have these little baskets and they're empty. Okay, I love these baskets. I bought these on Marketplace, local Marketplace. Hey, Lynn. Thanks, Donna. They are still in really pretty good shape. They have like a large hole area right here. So I'm going to put, you can get these at like Home Depot. It's just a little, I don't really know. But I'm going to put that over that hole. Okay, just for a little extra. I wonder if I should put this in the cocoa liner. Maybe I should do that. These aren't as big as you would get at like Home Depot, these cocoa liners, but it'll work because I really don't need it to show. So I put this plastic thing on top of the cocoa liner instead of under it. Okay. Now I have these, and boy do these need some attention. Bought these at the same time. I watered them once. It is a petunia, and it was $6, but this is a pretty big container. And I'm hoping this will get as big as that initially and then keep getting bigger. That's my plan anyway. That is my plan. Okay, so I'm gonna squeeze the sides. Gonna pull it out. Okay, and this is not very root bound, so a lot of times you'll want to scratch the roots if they're root bound, but I'm just going to leave it like that. I'm going to set it on top of that plastic dish. Okay. You want to buy some good dirt. I have, that is a plumeria. And I, shame on me, I stole that from the beach. I'm using Stay Green flower and vegetable soil. Yes, it is a plumeria. It has not bloomed for me yet, but I snipped some cuttings off of a huge one. It was probably the size of my front porch, no kidding, at these condos. And I, just with my hand, I broke them off. Those two pieces. Okay, so get some more dirt. Now, if you look at this real good, you can tell it needs some attention. So tomorrow, after doing all this, it should look a lot better after putting this stuff on it. Push it down in there real good. I'm hoping so anyway. All right. Oh my gosh, I love plumeria. I had one for years and I didn't cover it up one winter and it froze on me. But I do not have, I've never had a big one. But I'm using this stuff on it too, so it doesn't dry out. Okay, so we're gonna do this spreader sticker. Mainly on the plant. Not too much. Donna, honey, I will show you. I will show you again. This is the blooming and rooting. Remember the high number in the middle. I'll show you, Donna, the two bags or the two products. And you should watch the Donna, you should watch the replay so you can hear what I said this is good for. This what this actually does. But if you want to do a screenshot, it's spreader sticker. Okay, it's only two teaspoons per gallon of water. Oh, when I watched this guy on this video and he showed me his flowers, I was like, oh, that's amazing. And he said his plants like this in the hanging baskets are in full sun all day, every day. And they look just like Busch Gardens flowers. Okay, so I have another basket for one of these, but I'm not gonna hold you guys up doing that. I will do that when I get off of here and plant the other one. But I have another exact same basket and exact same plant. And see, you can tell not too much water came out of that because that spreader sticker keeps that water in your dirt. So let me hang this bugger up here. Oh, I can't. The hook is too small. I'll have to take it back where I had it. It won't fit on my front porch. Okay, so now, glad I'm on my front porch because I can just rinse it off. Does anybody have any questions? Okay. Now I also want to tell you, I bought this succulent. These succulents at Home Depot. And I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, possibly 10. 10 in this whole thing. And it was, okay, sounds expensive. It was $17, but that's a lot of succulents. If you buy them just the little itty bitty individuals, they're like $350, $450. I am not willing to pay that. But that is a lot of succulents for $17. And these are great. You know why? Because you don't have to water them very much. At all. Right? Okay, so I have this cute little thing. I have this cute little thing I want to put some in. So I'm going to get some dirt. Put it in here. Now, succulents, you only want to water if the soil feels super dry. That's the only time you want to water them. A lot of people make the mistake of watering them too much. And that's when they get root rot and like die on you. Okay, so I have a fork and a spoon. Turn this sideways. My can't remember what this call is called. Y'all help me out here. I think it's burrow's tail. I'm not sure. Anybody know what this is called? It's very fragile, so you don't want to you don't want to touch it too much, but I'm just going to stick it gently in that dirt and let it lay right there. Does anybody know what that's called? It is burrow's tail? Okay. So this one broke off and it doesn't have any roots growing. But if I break off, see how easy that was to pull those off? I'm just going to stick it in the dirt and it will do its thing. Gently stick it down in there. Oh my gosh, there's live video for you. Oh my gosh. Okay. No harm done. It's fine. I just need a little more dirt. This thing is back heavy. More dirt. Okay, just a little more dirt. Okay, I need to make sure it doesn't tip again. Okay. Maybe I should set that down here till I get my plants out. Sorry about that, y'all. Lynn, go to your Home Depot and see. They have a succulent section and see if they have these trays. These trays with everyone's different. I love that. So in that, I kind of want the ones that are going to trail. So I'm going to take this one out. Gently with a fork. Just going to dig down in there. Try to pop it up. Okay. That came up nice. And there's actually another one of those in here. Okay, let's try not to knock this over again. Okay, so this one, I'm gonna stick on this side. Because I want them to kind of trail out a little deeper. I love playing in the dirt. It is messy, but easy to clean up. Okay, so just put some dirt around that. Now I'm thinking, because the other ones are so big, I'm gonna do this one. And it just pulled right up. And look at this baby one growing off the leaf. See that baby one growing off of that? I'm gonna leave him in some dirt. So I'm gonna put this in the middle. Turn it around, push it down there, just a little bit of dirt right there. Okay, now my dirt is very dry and these are very dry, so I'm just going to go ahead girl. I have a bigger one exactly like this, a bigger one over here on this antique trunk. But I don't have anything planted in it because what I had in it did die over the winter. So I have to redo her. Okay, well, let me move this tray of succulents over here. And then I'm probably going to pot one more succulent in this crazy looking chicken thing. This is just all natural clay. Obviously somebody made it, but it's not marked or anything. But I got this at a yard sale and I thought, oh my gosh, that's so cute. So I'm going to put a succulent in that one. Oh my goodness, this thing is scaring me. I'm going to have to lean it up against something. Alright, so let's put our spreader sticker on here, very little. Because I don't think it needs much for the succulent, okay? And then we're going to use our blooming and rooting. Just a little tiny bit. Because you do not want succulents to sit in water. Okay, so we'll see how cute that ends up in a couple weeks. If it's growing a lot or... And I will take before pictures now. And in like 2 weeks, I will take pictures to see if there's any difference. Hey, Leisha. Lynn, I wished you would move back to Florida. I really do. Okay, are y'all bored yet? Are you bored yet? Throw that in there. Trying not to waste stuff. Oh, and another thing I was going to tell you is you do the spreader sticker and the rooting and blooming together 1 week. Then you use just the Miracle-Gro shake and feed the next week and water it. That's all you got to do. Not necessarily every week, but I think I'm going to do it every week. I'm going to try to. I thought it was adorable. And it's perfect for a succulent. Kind of looks like a chicken, kind of not. I don't know. Probably should have done that with my hand. Who else doesn't mind getting their hands dirty? I love it. I love planting stuff. I love to plant seeds with, thank you for the hearts and the thumbs up. Y'all don't even know how much that helps me. I love to plant seeds with my grandson, and we get to watch him grow. He just thinks that is the coolest thing. Okay, so now to decide which one to put in there. I'm thinking the ruffly one will look the cutest in the chicken. What do y'all think? The ruffly one or the purple or the green or the purple and green striped one. Y'all tell me which one you think. The ruffly one, Miss Ella? The ruffly one? It's cute, isn't it? Okay, we're going to do the ruffly one. Now, trying not to mess up any of the other ones. You know what? It might just pull up because I have not watered these. It is. It's pulling right out of there. It pulled right out of there. Isn't that cute? That is so pretty. And they don't tell you what each one is called, so I have no idea. Okay. Oh my gosh, that is cute, isn't it? All right, so for this, I'm going to use a spoon to fill it in. And because this is a raw clay pot, it of course would definitely dry out faster than say a plastic or a ceramic container. Yes, it looks like an ornamental cabbage. And I love those. You know, they used to sell those a lot down here. And I haven't seen any for a couple years. But I love those ornamental cabbage. And I kind of think if you don't have them by now, it's too late. Now my chicken's a little dirty, but I'll rinse it off. Y'all excuse my neighbor. I have the noisiest neighbor across the street. I say noisy, I mean noisy. Okay, so that is packed in there pretty good. So maybe I can shake some of that dirt off the sides. I'm going to reach my fingers in there and just kind of snug it down in there. Now, I will tell you, this tray of succulents had a little tiny cactus in it that had the, you know, the prickers that you do not want to touch. They get in your skin and they're like little hairs and they hurt and you can't get them out. I just took that out with a pair of tweezers and I threw it away because I don't want nothing like that that can hurt my grandkids. No, you don't want that place. Okay, so same thing with this one. I'm going to do a little of this spreader sticker. Because it's a succulent, I'm not going to do like a whole lot. A tiny bit on one side. A tiny bit on the other. That is supposed to keep my dirt where it doesn't get all dry and crumbly. And you want to water your succulents underneath of them. You don't want to water on top of them. So then a little of this Rootin' Bloomin'. Okay. Okay, and that should be plenty. Bye, Lynn. You have a great night. Okay, I will hose him off so he looks better. But look how cute. Isn't that adorable? Okay, so did y'all learn anything with all my mess? And if anybody would like the links to the stuff, if you would like the links to the stuff, I will post those on my page. Like I said, I couldn't find the blooming and rooting, and I could not find the spreader sticker at Home Depot. I did not go to Lowe's and look, but I doubt they have it either. I think your small lawn and garden, local lawn and garden stores would probably have it, but and it wasn't very expensive. And you saw what a tiny amount you put in a gallon of water. I mean, it's a win-win. It really is a win-win. Okay. Thank you. Y'all shoot me some hearts. And you can pass this video along if you'd like to. And I have a big mess to clean up. Y'all, it takes forever to set up for a video. You see all this stuff I had to, bring out here? Thank you so much. I appreciate it. Okay, well, I have more plants to plant, and I'm not going to bore you with that, but I'm going to do before pictures today, because we did this stuff today, and then in 2 weeks, I'll take pictures, and fingers crossed, they will look, a whole lot different, better. Bye, Emily. Okay, y'all have a great night. Thank you so much. I hope you enjoyed it. I know it was not a craft, but, I just love plants. Okay, I'll see y'all next time.